In the middle of the village stood a tall tower. Aladdin was feeling hungry, so he decided to go into the village to grab a quick bite. He got some bread from the local market. He was curious about the tower, so he asked a man nearby about it. The man replied, "In the tower is Princess Aurora, who has been cursed to sleep for 1,000 years. Nobody has been able to lift the curse because the tower is protected with a magical lock." Aladdin wanted to help the princess. He summoned the genie and asked him to open the lock. The genie spoke a funny little spell, and out of the lock popped out a little fairy. The fairy asked Aladdin a riddle which had not been solved in many years. Aladdin, with no fuss, answered the riddle. The little fairy was surprised by his intelligence and opened the lock. As Aladdin climbed the stairs, it seemed endless to him. Finally, at the top of the tower, he saw Princess Aurora sleeping in a beautifully decorated bed. Aladdin asked the genie to lift the curse. Slowly, Princess Aurora opened her eyes and awoke. Once awake, she thanked Aladdin and asked him how she can repay his kindness. Aladdin simply asked her to accompany him on his journey back home. Both of them were crossing a huge forest when Princess Aurora felt hungry. Just then, Aladdin remembered an old granny who lived in the forest. "That granny is me." They landed the carpet near a small hut. They both entered the hut and greeted the granny. Aladdin told the granny that the princess was hungry. The granny told Aladdin to bring a bowl of freshly prepared rice from the kitchen. Meanwhile, the granny said, "You know, princess, Aladdin is a great man. He uses all his magical powers to help people in need instead of using it for himself." The princess was surprised on hearing this. Before leaving, she said, "Aladdin, you have so much power, but thought of using it for people in need? I shall do so. Thank you for showing me the true meaning of being rich." That day, the princess took a pledge that, like Aladdin, she will use her treasures and riches to help the downtrodden of her empire. So saying, the princess said goodbye and left for her palace. So, did you like the story?